Hello, I am Chris Menard. Welcome to my channel. We're going to take a look today at figuring out the Social Security break-even age. I will do it two different methods. Method one that I'm going to do in Excel, you could actually do on your calculator on your mobile phone, but then I'll also plot it out in Excel. Two different examples, one to show you that the formula works, and then two, we'll look at some actual averages from the Office of the Social Security Administration. Let's dive in right now. This file will be available for you to download. This is part of my Excel online training course. Example one, does it work? Notice I have $5,250. That number is not even possible. The maximum in 2024 that you could get with SSA benefits is $4,873, which I believe is about $58,000 a year. But just to prove the formula works, here you go. I'm looking at, do I want to take early retirement, that's the official term, at age 62, and I plugged in $1,500, or do I want to get full retirement at age 67, and this is the number that's not realistic, the $5,250, but this will give me a whole number in my formula. I know that that is 60 months, but if you want to do the math, the 67, C8 minus C7 times 12 is 60 months. What is the difference? I could get $5,250 if I wait to age 67, or I can get $1,500 now, that's $3,750. What is the total amount you will receive from age 62 up till you start getting it at 67? That is going to be simply the $1,500. We get $1,500 a month times that 60 months we calculated. That is $90,000. So here's your formula. Once you know the months, once you know the difference, and again, you could do this with your calculator on your mobile phone, and then you multiply that and get the total. The break-even in months is the total amount divided by that difference that you're going to get if you were to hold off on retirement, which is $3,750, 24. That is 24 months. An important point, it is 24 months from age 67. So if we look over here, and I'm going to explain this earlier, this is method two. So method one is just doing this formula over here in column D that I did. Method two is we're saying 24 months, so if I scroll down, there's 1,500, 3,000, 4,000, 500. So at age 67, we start getting that 5,250. I've already highlighted this, or maybe I didn't. Where do these numbers match? And right here, after 2 years, that is 2 years, 126,000, 126,000. So after this, we're much better off at 67 years of age. So that is your break-even in age for Social Security benefits. Now let's go look at it with realistic numbers. This is where I would encourage you to go plug in from the Social Security Administration website. You can go sign in, pull up your numbers. Right now, they look at the past 35 years of work history and your highest earnings. So here we go again, and I've even got a link here. We'll talk about this in 1 second. So these numbers that I'm showing for early retirement and full retirement and delayed, that is from the Office of Actuary for the Social Security Administration, and I got those numbers from either December 2023 or sometime in 2024, so they are very accurate. Let's look at 62 versus 67 again. I'm not going to sit here and label everything. I'm going to just do the math. We know we got that number minus that number. There's our dollar difference. We know we've got 60 months. I'm not going to do the formula. I'm just going to plug in 60. What is the total? We're getting this amount monthly for 60 months. I'm going to label that one TOTAL. So the break even in months is that total divided by the difference we will get. 586, 132 months. Let's do just a little bit of, let's use the INT function. That'll round the number down. So that is 11 years. Or you could do the 132 divided by 12, and then that's going to be 0.07 times 12. So one, it looks like 11 years and 1 month, basically, is where somewhere where this should be breaking even. Let's talk about what I did over here now in column H, I, and J. I put in 62 and just made it 62 for 12 months. I started at 0 and went to 11, and then you turn 63, and that goes back to 0. I came in here and I used the count function to keep counting this number, and I did a 3D reference referencing cell D7. So that works. So now when we turn 67, we're going to get 1,884. And again, we're looking for 11 years, 11 years from 67. So here we go. 1,884. There's the formula I used here. I referenced cell D8 instead of D7. And again, I'm using that count function. I'm doing the math in my head. 11 years from 67 sounds like 78 to me. Just scroll down through here. Keep going. Maybe that one. It's correct, I'll tell you that. 528. Yeah, there you go. $58. Perfect, right in there. So at that point, that is where retiring at 62 and getting benefits versus retiring at 67, that's where the break even occurs. I am not considering any taxes or any other items. This is just pure numbers, by the way. You would definitely need to start looking at taxes, maybe see a certified financial planner. I am not a certified financial planner. Cool feature here. There's a link I gave you. This will take you to the Social Security Administration. It will let you figure out what is your life expectancy according to them. So you first start off picking male or female. You pick your date of birth. I'll throw something in here. August 10th, I'll put in my DOB, 73. And there you go right there. This is my current age, and they're expecting me to go to 82.1. If I wait till 62, now my life expectancy actually goes up a little bit. 67, it goes up a little bit more. Go back, and you can change this again. Trust me, if you pick female, if you're female, your life expectancy is longer than male. I think 2 to 3 years, depending on who you are. Cool feature right here. There's that website there. So the whole purpose of this is just to help you make a decision about when you want to retire. When is your life expectancy? I know we hate talking about stuff like that, but it's something to consider when you're looking at your retirement. Finally, if you get stuck, I gave you this example one completed. So if you say, Chris, how did you do this? This one's actually already filled out. And I did highlight this one in yellow to show you that they break even. I appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe to my Excel online training courses. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up and share it. Also, I have training classes on Teams, OneNote, and Copilot. Have a good one.